खिड़की खोले बाजू वाली लड़की हाय 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 सुबह सुबह जब खिड़की खोले बाजू वाली लड़की हाय दिल मेरा बोले हेलो हाउ आर यू
Yes, Siddharth, we can start.
Okay. Hello, everyone. Good afternoon to all. So today I'm going to present you the KSS on IdeaBox. So what is IdeaBox? So we provide a different topic in each language every day for our authors to write a story on it. Just a second, let me. So why are we suggesting a new topic every day to authors so that they can show so all the authors can publish the pratilipis. So we are providing the new topics for them to publishing the pratilipis. Now initial launch, so it was initially launched as an experiment from experiment box in November 2019. So this is the first week response, as you can see, 9, 23, 14. These are the published count of first week of launching the IdeaBox. Now, what were the results we got from this experiment? How much published increase? So on the first week of April 2020, we got the result as an you can see the this last row as a publish of first week of April of pratilipis published from the IdeaBox. So it was nearly 800 on an average 800 content every day, which was 9 to 10% of our daily overall platform published. So the IdeaBox it was a good response from the authors for IdeaBox. So we can conclude that the experiment has successful, and now we need to launch this as an feature. So initially IdeaBox was launched as an experiment by ARP from Experiment Box. Thanks to ARP for the support into Android and launching it from the experiment box. So now what next to launch the feature? So it needed to be launched as a feature. Why? Because now it has a great response from the author, so we can maintain it easily and update it easily. We can add any new feature in it, like live serial and series support and anything. And it will be easy to expand on a large scale, as it will be launched as a feature on our microservices. So first question is, in which service we are going to launch this? So it was a very long conversation between me, Gauri, Giridhar, Kshitij and Shelly. Thanks to you all guys for guiding me at that time. So after that, we decided to launch this into the event service and convert event service to originator service. Now, why to do this? So it was the thing that right now we have the IdeaBox. If tomorrow we have any new feature like this, in which we are we will be providing a feature or topic or something like that, in which authors can publish their pratilipis. So for that, all types of originators, we do not need to create a new support or let's say new service, or we do not need to merge it or adapt it into any other microservice. So we wanted to create a service which can from which we can create any originator in future if it arrives then easily, and we can expand that very easily. So in future, any kind of new originator can be published from it or can be launched from it, and make schema like that, so it can be easily adapt the new feature. So just like, let me give you an example. Right now, if we want to publish a feature like on every festival, we will be providing the one topic or let's say one banner on the homepage to every authors, and we can share some detail of that festival, and authors have to publish the pratilipis from it. But unlike the event, it is not restricted on the time limit. It can be published from any time. And it will be, all the pratilipis of it will be visible to every author. And unlike IdeaBox, it will not be published daily. It will be published only on the festivals. So from originator service, we can easily publish it. We just have to add one We just have to add one originator type into here, like event, idea box, and the festival or whatever the new name suggests. And rest of the all the data can be used as same for the as for the using for the right now originator service. We can use that for that new type, that new originator. So why we can use this easily? Because the one another benefit is there. It provides us the differentiated by ID and type. So like event service and event and idea box will not fetch the data of that new because it will be having a different type and ID. And one more thing, we have a direct mapping of originator ID with Pratilipi series and live series in the respective tables. So we can directly fetch this all by giving the ID. We do not have to provide any mapping or we do not have to call the multiple services to get the Pratilipis of or to combine the responses. So this was the basic idea to create originator service. Now how a request call for the originator for idea box. So first init service calls the originator service and get the idea box meta. So on the home page we do not show any Pratilipi. We just show the idea box name and its image and a Pratilipi count. The list of the Pratilipi will be shown if we click on the idea box. So first init is calling the originator service and it fetches all the idea box metadata. And for that idea box ID, if we needed Pratilipis, then it calls the Pratilipi service to fetch all the Pratilipis and then send to the client. Now, how, when, and who feed the data to the idea box and this originator right now. So a cron job runs at every night, which adds the idea box in each language from the Google Sheet. And in the Google Sheet, our AEMs fills all the data for everyday idea box. Thanks to AEM for taking responsibility of this. Now, which are the major difficulties which we faced during this? So first major difficulty was service and schema design, like which service in which we will publish it or what type of schema we'll be designing it for it. But as I told already, this was the solution which we used for that. Another is minor and tricky cache in the originator service. So this was what like the idea box on homepage will be static for all the day. They will not change for the rest of the day. So we can provide we can set it into the cache for one day. But the content will be static. It will not be changed. Like idea box will be same, and once it changed for the another day, it will be not changed for the next day. So we do not use Redis here. We just use the Nginx caching so that because it's a static caching, and to invalid, and also after the 24 hours, it should be the invalidate automatically. But in Nginx, if we set like 24 hours invalidation, and if someone is rebuilding this service, then all the cache will be invalidated at that time, and the timer will be set from this that time. So to solve that, we created that whenever the init service calls the originator service for the idea box metadata, it will send the date its respective date to the originator service, and based on that date, it will generate the new request and we will not fetch from the cache. So based on the date, we are using the difference. We are differentiating in the cache, and we are using a static cache into the originator service. So okay, and so where are we today? What is the result today? What is the publishing count of today that we are getting? So right now, nearly 1200 to 800 of publishing Pratilipis are published in each day for all the combining all the languages, which is nearly 17 to 18% of our overall publishing from platform. This is the sample sample table from the analytics. So yes, this is basically how the idea box is shifted from experiment box to the as a service.
Thank you, Siddharth. Really nice presentation. Let's have question and answers.
Yeah, sure. Yes, Gauri has a question.
Gauri has a question. Yes, please.
Hey, Siddharth. I remember when we were actually building this particular service, there were a lot of confusion around when we should build a new microservice and when we should not build a new microservice. So can you share that particular knowledge with everybody?
Yeah, sure. So basically, at that time, I came up with the approach that we should build a new microservice and not include it to the any another microservice. So at that time, Gauri told me one thing, and we have gone through the discussion that when should we launch the new microservice. So it is that it all thing should be we have to find the what is the requirement of the new microservices. Like what I can say basically is like a Pratilipi, like any another microservice. So it has the totally different context. It has totally different area of context, and it is needed on a different scale. So we just have to identify based on the what is the use and what we actually require for our feature, and based on that we have to decide whether we should go for the new microservice or not. Because as we are increasing the new microservices, it is also come with the maintenance and updating of that all microservices. So yes,
Gauri, do you have another question? Okay,
any other questions?
Yeah, Shubham has a question.
Yes, hi Siddharth. So just wanted to know, how much the performance of this particular feature idea box, how much does it get influenced from the activity that the AMs do on the spreadsheet that you share? Do you have any data on this, or any insights on this?
Can you explain a little bit?
You mentioned there was a sheet where AMs update what ideas essentially have to be put forward to the authors to then write about, right?
Yeah.
How much of the performance of the feature is influenced by the activity and the selection of those ideas which the AMs do?
Okay, yeah, sure. Just a second. Let me share with the screen. Okay.
I mean, in fact, the AMs who are playing around with this feature would also have certain idea, I think.
Yeah, sure. Okay. I'm sharing the graph of over the base or time of the period, how much it increased. Just give me a minute, I'm finding that graph. I have saved today morning
itself. Okay.
But if I may answer your question, Shubham, Siddharth will share the screen, but it definitely is one of the variable which actually make people think about ki, whether they should be participated in today's idea or not. So if you are interested in against what ideas, how the participation has been in different languages, or so say the same idea might work differently in different language, that definitely you can, we have the entire list of ideas mapped against states, and you have the published count here in Amplitude, so you can always
check. Yeah, you can see I have set this from the very first of its launch, from the first day till today, and you can see from the graph how much the publishing count has increased.
Okay.
You can see that on today's is 1,053 for today's.
Around 1,200, 1,300, it's almost constant.
Yeah.
And around which it oscillates up and down.
Yeah.
Okay. Interesting. Thank you.
Yeah, Aishwarya has a question.
Rijas has shared one link. Let me show you if you guys want to see it. So yeah, this is the link Rijas has shared. We can see here the publishing difference on each different languages, impact in each different languages.
You have to put publish where type is not equal to update. That's why the numbers are so high. But that's okay. So I'll forward you this with the you can share the graph. Aishwarya has a question.
Yeah. Hi, Siddharth. Yeah, here.
Yeah, hi.
So, like, Siddharth, like, you told me what IdeaBox is doing right now, or how it's performing. What does the future hold for IdeaBox, apart from, like, having an event-based system there? Is IdeaBox going to be focused on just increasing the top-line publishing numbers, or are we looking at something broader in the future?
Okay. Thank you for reminding me that I forgot to told you that in last 1 month we have also provided the series and live serial supports from IdeaBox, and we are going to build a client on that in the next few releases. So in the next few releases we will be having a series and live serial supports from the IdeaBox, and also for the performance we have provided the GraphQL support API, like ID and type types API from Pratilipi service for this. So in next few releases we will be covering the this series and live serials publishing support from the IdeaBox. Is it what you're asking?
Yeah, that's what I was asking. Like, I just wanted to know the future. So fine.
Yeah, thank you so much. Yes, Gauri has another question.
Is it that, so I remember when we are actually thinking about the whole event service and the way IdeaBox was supposed to be built over there, there are a few things what we thought that we'll do it beforehand, like building test cases. I'm sure you had like 30 rounds of code reviews done by me.
Yeah.
So I want to, I want you to share your learnings from that particular process, whether it added any benefit, whether it actually slowed you down, or whatever your learnings were there from that.
Yeah, sure. Thanks for reminding me. I just thought to add that, but I forgot. Yeah, sure. So when I was working on this IdeaBox, though it was my very first time to work on the DB schema in Pratilipi particularly. I has never worked on DB schema in Pratilipi before that, as I am new for even very things in Pratilipi. So, and it was very first time to work with even Gauri. So when we started working, building that, I was lacking with very few things, like I wrote a whole feature like 1200 lines of the all the IdeaBox. Then Gauri directly reviewed my PR. She told me to write first the test cases for each and everything. So test cases for each and every request, like what API I am going to build, what API's response will be I am expecting in each and every cases. Even I am remember that for each API I have written nearly 4 to 5 test cases, including all the 400s and 500s. So it was that time it slowed me very down, and it was very like I felt very difficult for it. But right now it is very helpful for me. So right now I am converting originator event service to originator service. So all the endpoints will be changed, and all the DB schemas, DB queries, all the table name will be changed. So right now, if I will make a very small mistake, then I have to check all the I have to call all the endpoints and all the APIs of event service, because all the endpoints are going to be changed and all the queries are going to be changed. But right now I have the test cases. So what I will do, I will just do change and run the test case, and it will run all the APIs with all the conditions and with all the test cases. All the 400s, 500s, all the queries and all the endpoints will be validated by itself. With the time limitation also, we have also test. She also told me to write a test case for time limitation, like this query is taking this much time, this query is API is taking this much time. So we have also built a test case for time validation also. So right now I prefer on any microservice or in any feature we are building, we just need to write down the test cases. It is very helpful because whenever in future you are changing anything, you do not have to wasting time on the testing that each API. Right now, as we fix anything like a minor bug we fixes, we have to call that API, and we just neglect that part. But I think it nearly takes the 20-30% of our building time to call that API. But if we have test case ready, we just have to run that one test case, and it will run all the APIs and it will validate it for us. The second thing I have launched the whole feature, like each and every API at the same time. Then Gauri taught me at that time also. Just divide it into the different parts and then create a PR, so that each different part can be also tested also and we can push it to the prod also. So do not create the dependency and try to divide it into the parts, so that what happens is if you have a like whole feature build and you if you will give even if you build it, it will take 1 or 2 day or maybe more time to test on the gamma to all the scenarios. So for that time, nobody will able to push it from push their code. Also, I faced the difficulty that when it was on the gamma, I remember that it has a dependency on the two other services also, like I have to left change into the Pratilipi service and I have pushed my changes into PEG or any other services. So what happened that Giridhar and Rajat needs to push something in urgent. So I have to revert my all the changes from gamma to from gamma and gamma development back, and then again I have to push that. So to remove that dependency, we just have to measure that it is not dependent on any other changes and it can be pushed into the divided blocks. Yeah.
Oh, sorry.
Anything else you want to cover me, Gauri?
No, I guess that was good.
Yeah, Mohit, you have a question.
How did you write the test case for a 5xx?
If this like we can call the request and let's say you have a wrong schema name or let's say divide by zero or any other error, so we have to write down we have written down all the exceptions for that, like divide by zero, like no data found, or Pratilipi already existing, or for all that we have written down the try and catch error for that. So they will be raising directly if they found anything of this type of error, they will be directly raising the 4xx and 5xx for them, and we are catching.
So ideally we always raise a 4xx if we can understand that this is a condition which is there is the 5xx only comes when your code actually fails. You are not failing it intentionally. So I couldn't understand that
So basically test case was not a part of a code na. We have written down the different file, and that file send a request to my API. Now my request is if it faces 5xx, then it returns the request code as 5xx, 500. If it is successfully, then it will be return the r dot request code as a 200. So I am comparing there at the code that 200 is, 400 is, or 500 is, and based on that we can identify na ki whether it is 500 or any other.
So there is a case in the API which can cause a 5xx.
Yeah. Repeat.
So malab use according to that, there should be a case in the API which could
cause the 5xx. Yes.
Malab, I don't know, but what case that that satisfies that 5xx for a criteria? Malab, can you malab, a little
so,
bit?
Okay. So let's say. Right now I need to convert originator event service to originator, but on the database I have converted renamed the table created a new database as originator and table as originator. Now if in my one of the API there is left event dot select star from event dot event, so it will be raised the 5xx as event data event table is not found on that. So whenever my test case we call my API, it will return the r dot status code at 500 and r.text as a no table found, whichever we are getting as a in the postman and whatever we are testing. So then test case will compare the status code and then we can identify this is the there is the error.
That should be fine.
Yeah. Okay. So any other questions from anyone, or any doubt or anything you want to cover me?
Yeah, this is Avinash. I have a question.
Yeah, Avinash.
Okay, so you wrote test cases for the originator service. So is there currently any sort of integration with Jenkins or any sort of automated testing?
No. That part is not done yet. Automatic testing with the Jenkins of test cases is not done yet. That is left. But for that that will be also I thought about that. That will be also a trick of a little bit tricky, because you have to update the test case of that file each time, and on the Jenkins file we can write that whenever it is running it can include call that APIs. But as you know, there is many variation in calling the API. Like so many APIs will fail only for some users and not for all the users. So for that kind of thing, automation will not work, because as you have to provide only that user IDs, or let's say we have to automate for any other thing. But yes, it's not right now on Jenkins. It's just on a local system. You have to run locally.
Okay, so what about if you have to test all the APIs for a Gamma environment or a prod environment? So how do you do that? So as a developer, I'm asking, so if I had to build a new API in the event service, so how would I ensure I run my test correctly?
So right now, whatever the test case I have written, you can run it on the locally. If they are working locally, then they are good. And if you want to test it on the Gamma, then change the endpoints to the Gamma endpoint, or run from the SSH system, or just tunnel and run from the local system to ensure that.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah.
Can you explain me that how, what was the tunneling wala thing?
If you need to, if you want to test every API on Gamma, then all the endpoints will not be open to call it directly from the open public endpoint. So if you want to test right now, let's say I have three APIs onto the on event service, on Devo, Gamma, and Prod. Now I want to test that on the Gamma, then endpoint which are not public, then you have to call it from the creating a tunnel, and then you have to call it from the Gamma.
Cool.
Any other questions or doubt, or want to cover me anything in topic?
Hey Siddharth, I had a question here.
Yeah, Kuldeep.
So where did you write these tests?
In an event service, there will be test case file. Let me show you directly.
So they're like unit tests and not integration tests, is it?
Yeah. They are unit test cases, not integration. Okay.
You mentioned somewhere that you were writing a Postman, so I thought you had a Postman testing going on.
I want to just mention that the response, how we are figuring the response and 4x's and 5x's in Postman, same thing we will be doing here.
Cool. So all of these tests are unit tests, right?
Yeah. So let me share you, if you want to just visit on it. So in event service, there is this test folder, and you will find the IdeaBox get list, post delete. Let me show you one. So this is IdeaBox add API. This all add APIs, including this image. My screen is visible to everyone right now?
Yeah.
Okay. So these are the different kinds of test cases which we covered for delete API, for non-ID API. We have to ensure that they can run directly. Like if you need to delete API, if you will run this, it will directly delete API. How? So basically, it will first create the post API, and then whatever the IdeaBox ID return, it will try to delete that API. So that, you know, if you want to delete test delete API, we just write down the request with IdeaBox ID or whatever the ID by hard coding it. But in this, Gauri suggested to do this, like try to make it as max independent as possible. So whenever someone will call this, it will first create IdeaBox and then delete it, so we can ensure both the thing, right? We do not have to hardcode IdeaBox ID each time. So this is how all
correct.
The test
cases. That makes sense.
Yeah, so in this way, all these APIs are making. So whenever you will run it, it will definitely test that API, no matter what are the parameters. If the parameters needed, it will be generate the parameters on each end. So like I have to test the duplicate request. So it will first create one request and then create another duplicate request. You do not have mm-hmm. to duplicate data. So this way, okay. We just try to cover. Yeah, you can visit this, all these
things. Cool, I'll visit it. Thank you.
Any other questions or doubts? Yeah, Shubham.
Yes, hi Siddharth.
Yeah, hi.
So essentially the intent of this feature is very much similar to the intent of the events feature, or rather the events cup whole process that we already have. And there we put a monitoring kind of an execution here. We are just providing an idea. It's not a contest, and still we are getting daily some 1200, 1300 new contents. So, I mean, this is interesting. Without and events wala thing is already something that's going on. So, do you see these two features coexisting later on, or do you see one of them cannibalizing the other? Yeah, I just wanted to be
confused. Can you repeat the last thing? Your voice is breaking.
Yes. So, what I was trying to say is because the intent of this feature and the events wala current feature that we have is very similar. And yeah, we are getting almost 1,000 new publishers. And without running a contest or actually putting a monetary prize. So this might actually may or may not cannibalize the events for the feature in the long run. Or do you think these two features would coexist in future?
Yes, there. According to me, they should be coexist. The one reason is in event we do not allow participants to read the pratilipi. In event we just the motive of event, as far as I know, the motive of events to encourage the writers or encourage the author. But in but in idea box we do not hide the pratilipi. All the pratilipis which are published into the event, we do not publish it directly. No one can read until the participants, until the event is over. But on the idea box, daily readers, authors are writing the activities on daily basis, and readers can should be on the daily basis. Like say right now the lockdown is currently going on, and we have also provided the topic of lockdown. So right now authors are writing the stories on lockdown right now. So all the readers should be able to read it right now. What is the point if we allow them to read after the after the event?
Makes sense. And maybe that's why it's working so well. So interesting. Thank you.
Any other questions so far?
We'll wait for 2 more minutes, Shita.
Sure.
Thank you, everyone.
Thanks, Siddharth.
Thank you everyone for being a part of my first KSS in Pratham.
सुबह सुबह जब खिड़की खोले बाजू वाली लड़की हाय तुम मेरा बोले हेलो हाउ आर यू तुम मेरा बोले हेलो हाउ आर यू